Hey folks, what's going on? I just wanted to show you how to use the voiceover changer. So first, we locate it inside of our folders that we extracted all the files to. We find our start http.bat file, and we double click on it. I hope you already installed this so you could go through all the process on your own. It's not that hard, but you have to give administration authority to the app. Once the app starts up, you'll start seeing all the background loading stuff in your command prompt. It's that black screen that's open. So just wait for everything to load, and then click start. This is your first time using this app. You'll download a bunch of stuff, so just wait for all that stuff to finish, and you'll get into the program. So as you see, I have a bunch of different RVC voiceovers models. I've created some, and I've downloaded some from Discord. So right now I'm just showing you how to upload some RVC models. So you want to locate your file on your hard drive with your PHC file. PHC, what is it called? So I have an Angry Video Game Nerd one. It's a PTH file. So you load that one into the top, and in the second one, you load the index version of that. It should have the longer file name. And just click update. I'm sorry, upload. And from there, you close out that. You load it up by clicking on it once, and then you'll see the default picture. You want to export the Onyx. This will take a few minutes to process. What it's doing is taking those two files, just upload it, and make it into a lighter version of that file, I believe, which is easier on your computer to use. So we'll just wait for this to process. So once the file has finished processing and creating a new file for you, hopefully there's no errors. You'll see it inside of your command prompt on the bottom. There's any errors. Didn't read any errors. So I'll put a new file for you, and you'll see that hopefully inside of the model directory inside of the application. I usually save it there because it's easier for me to find when I re-upload it. So locate the folder where you have your application. So locate your version of the voice changer application. Open up the folders. Go down to your model directory. It's in its own folder. It should say model DIR. Place it in a number, a folder that you want the voice to be in. Now go back to edit. Back to upload, select the top file, and find your Onyx. Click open and click upload again. It'll upload and then find another photo for you to use. I'm trying to remember right now where I actually put the photo I wanted to use. Click close. And now you have your character. So whenever you click on the top of where all the characters are, the program will switch to that voice. It'll take a couple of seconds, maybe a minute or so to actually happen. That's your input for how loud your mic is going to be, your output for how much your headphones are going to hear. The tune is where you change the voice pitch, usually between positive 12 and negative 12. Once you finish, you click save settings. I use suppression number 1 with the noise because I have a lot of background noise here and a silence threshold of either 0.1 or like 0.158, somewhere in the middle. I use harvest because it's normal, I guess. DO is a light version and crape is a higher version if you have a GPU, which I don't have a GPU. Chunk is your buffer. I use 128. It still doesn't work well. Extra is, I don't know what that means. Maybe another thing. I think it uses your GPU. I don't have a GPU, as you can see. I only have a CPU. SIO is where I record short clips. Audio, client, and server. I use client because I can't use server. It stutters too much for me. This is your bitrate. That's your inputs and outputs. And monitor, I believe, if you're running a line out of your computer, you could also hear it's outside monitors, or external monitors, I should say. Go back to client. Click on advanced settings, and these are the settings that I use. Trend cadence, usually 300, is what I use. And that's pretty much it. When using male-to-male voices, it's usually fine to leave the tune at 0. But if you're doing a female, I find out that 7 to 12 works. But when you're recording an audio file for a female, as a male with a deeper voice, or even a female with a deeper voice, or anybody with a deeper voice, I usually have to use a voice that sounds like this. I sound like this. Make it sound like you have a sore throat. And that would translate better, make the voice sound more feminine. I don't know why, it just happens. So as you click the start button, you'll see in your command prompt that it's warming up. So you have to wait for that to happen. Your buffer will start buffering, and your resolution, I believe, will start going up. That means that it's inputting audio. That's what the res means. I don't know what's the whole, what it actually stands for. Choose whatever input your mic is on. Choose the output of whatever your speaker or your headphones are using. And then when you're ready, you click on start and you start recording your audio. For me, it's very, it skips too much when I record. So I just record little bits and pieces at a time. When you finish, click stop. And then you see your file show up.
Hey, UFO, it's me, the nerd. Video game nerd, what are you doing today? I'm about to review an N64 game.
So after that, you can download the file to your hard drive. When you're using the ISO, you have to download each file right after you recorded it, because otherwise it'll get lost. It'll be overwritten. You save the input and the output for a file. The input is the original recording. The output is what was used as a voice changer. So every time you click on a new character to load the model, you'll see that it warms up. And you just wait for your buffer and your computer to start, get ready to use the program to use the voiceover character. So click start again. And make sure you use that, why is somebody talking like this? I'll play that audio for you right now.
Bloody moon in my daylight, even more than I would lie. It's the body got the real fight. It was the one same sailor mode.
So you press stop and see how the audio is really crappy. And I'll play back to the sound now.
Bloody moon in my daylight, even more than I would lie.
See, by not changing the tone, all you hear is my voice going, la la la. So that's one thing you have to keep in mind. Always change your tune if you're going from, I use quote unquote gender to gender. I usually use 10 with this voice. We'll start again. Use that audio once I click start.
Fighting evil by moonlight, living love by daylight. Every morning was a real fight. It was a once in sailor mode.
Fighting evil by moonlight, living love by daylight. Every morning was a real fight. It was a one-chase.
For me, the voice changer is pretty crappy. But this is an alternative way how to use the voice to make it sound actually pretty good. It takes a little time, and you can use it online in a Google Collab for free. For now. Until they shut it down. Hopefully they don't. So in the next video, I'll show you that website. And I'll show you where to get more models. Click on stop to end your session. Close out the program and you're done. Watch the next video. And it's 3:44 in the morning, so that's what I'm doing is. And that's why I keep stuttering. But I stutter anyway. Because I can't speak well.